Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how I organize and clean out my crazy cabinet style apartment pantry. Yes, crazy. It's the struggle all the time, just keeping it neat and clean. So I was like, you know what? I need to go out. I need to purchase some things to help me with that. And I've tried looking up on YouTube for cabinet style pantry organization videos, and they're very rare, and there's not a lot of videos on cabinet style pantries, so I figured why not record my own and show you guys how I like to organize mine. So if you guys are interested in those kind of videos, then hit that like button, because I also have a fridge, maybe freezer too, fridge and freezer organization video coming soon, because that is the next project I will be working on. So if you guys like those kind of videos, hit that subscribe button and keep on watching. This is my embarrassing pantry. Ready? 3, 2. Ta-da! So, that is what we're working with today, you guys. Also, I'll show you guys up here. This is my, where I keep my cereals, my taller things, like my flour, extra rice, and stuff like that. I like have ice cream cones up there, extra flour, extra rice. I actually need to fill this up, so maybe I'll do that too. So this will also be included in the video as well. So again, to give you an overview, this is the top, and we're just gonna do a small overview. All right, guys, so I'm gonna probably start with this section right here, all of this, and then I'll probably just do the top last, because that's fine. Okay, you guys, so the first thing I'm gonna do is probably take everything out, like everything out at the same time, which is gonna kind of give me a little anxiety, but it's gotta be done. I'm just gonna take everything out and either put them on the floor and on my counters. I'm probably gonna speed through this part because it's kind of boring to me just taking everything out. So I'll probably just speed through it. So you guys, after watching that clip back, the last clip you guys just saw, I realized my shirt was a little bit too big right here and it kept falling down. So I changed into a t-shirt because I'm pretty sure you guys don't want to see that. So yeah, I already cleaned out this first shelf and I'm working on my second shelf. And yeah, keep watching. So one thing that I've always used are these things from the dollar store where you can stack seasonings. I think it says seasoning organizer. You can put your little seasonings on there. And I do have my seasonings organized on another one in my seasoning cabinet. So I'm going to use this for cans because that's what I've been doing. So it's been working out great. So quick tip, get these at the dollar store. $1, you guys. Can't go wrong. I mean, $1. And you just stack all your cans on there in whatever order you like. And there you go. The only downside is that I can't fit a lot of things inside of my pantry space, which is another reason why I'm doing this video, because you guys can get ideas for yours if you have the same issue. Okay, we have a lot more green beans than we do corn because my husband and I are addicted to green beans. Like, that's our favorite vegetable at the moment, which changes all the time. It's like green beans and broccoli. I'm all about, like, I kind of get a little OCD about how I want everything to look, like all the labels facing the same way. Is anybody else like that? I feel like other people are neat. Like, I want to feel like I'm at the store picking out my vegetables, you know? And I have more. So, the cleanup after this is going to be so much fun. Not really. So I had to make some adjustments off camera because I decided to incorporate my Lazy Susan at the top just for my canned fish and whatever else I find to put in there, but just a update. Okay, you guys, I had to turn the camera around so I can actually show you what the heck is going on and what I just did. So, I have all my canned beans back there, all my green beans, and all my corn in the back. I use green beans more often than corn, so I have all the green beans up front. Then I have all my kidney beans. I also have some other types of beans back there, some butter beans and some other things back there, just beans. And then here I have all my canned fish. Like I said, we stocked up for the corona, so we have some canned fish here that we can easily grab and go. So yeah, I just wanted to update you. So this is how this top section looks. I don't know if I'm gonna put anything else right here. I probably will end up putting something here just because, again, we are limited on space, you guys. So it is going to be, you know, very tight, but at least everything is in one place and organized the way that I like it. And I can find everything I need way easier. I mean, this is so cute to me. I'm obsessed with this Lazy Susan, you guys. I also probably will do a couple things off camera just for the sake of time because my video is getting longer and longer and because this obviously takes more time. And also, I'm recording on my phone, you guys. I don't know if I already mentioned that, I probably did, but I am recording on my phone, so in order to save some space, I'm having to kind of do a little bit of things off camera, but I will obviously update you guys. Okay, the next small update, I have some little chicken sausages that I've added in this little container from the dollar store with my packet of tunas in the back, you know, these little pack ones you can get, just so that I have a place to put those. And again, I'm really liking how this turned out. Love my Lazy Susan. Keeps everything super organized and yeah, can find what I need. So, overview of my top section. Now moving on to this section, which I'm still trying to figure out. Okay, you guys, so update. Again, let me just show you. Up here we have all the canned stuff. Like anything canned, canned fish, canned beans, canned vegetables, everything's up here. Then down here, I decided to put all my husband's favorite to-go snacks that are just quick and easy for him. And I have his Pringles over there. And then I have some soups, which he loves having those for snacks. So I just put his go-to snacks right there. That way it's easy for him to kind of find and he doesn't have to like duck all the way down to the bottom. But I'm going to also add a ton more snacks. So this is going to be like a lot of snacks here. Then this next section is going to be all my pastas and pasta sauces. And then at the bottom, I haven't really decided yet. And sorry, my floor is messy because I just kind of cleaned out my pantry. After this, I'll probably be doing a whole kitchen cleaning video, or just do it in general. But I just wanted to update you guys because it's kind of been a struggle trying to figure out how I want to do things, how I want to organize, because there's just so much stuff. I actually just threw away a ton of stuff. So yeah, this is my snack section of the pantry. So we have some soups, Pringles, we have some different kinds of chips. And again, look how much neater they fit. If they were too big, they'd cover up everything. And then you can't really see what you have all the way in the back of the pantry. And that's kind of one of my biggest things in doing this pantry organization is really being able to see what we have. Because a lot of times we'll go out to the store and purchase something else that we already have at home, but we forgot or we couldn't find it because it's stuffed all the way in the back and we couldn't see it. Other things are bigger and hiding it. So I really wanted to focus on mainly being able to see what we have. So that's why I opened these chips so that they would be smaller in size so that we could see every single thing we have. I can see that I have soups back there. I can see that I have Pringles back there. I can see that I have, you know, snacks right here. So it's just easy to navigate and find what I need to find when I'm looking for it. So really quick, I forgot to mention that I purchased these also at Ross. They're just jars. I have no idea what I want to fill them with yet, but I figured they'd come in handy and they were super inexpensive. This one was $4.49. Nice big jar to keep stuff in. And then this one, which is so pretty. I wanted to get more than one, but I was like, let me just calm down because I was on a budget. This one is $3.49. So super adorable. And this actually matches the decor in my house. As you can see, I have some different variation of blues going on. And it's so pretty. I really want this one actually to be like on a counter since it matches my decor, like with something in it. So I may put like my chia seeds in it or something like that, or I might use it in the pantry. Still unsure of what I'm gonna do, but definitely knew that it was a steal and I had to pick it up. So I wanted to share it with you guys. Okay, you guys, after countless trial and errors and figuring out what works best in my pantry, I finally came up with this as my end result. So as you guys can see, I have all my cereals up top and I kept kind of up here the same. I just kind of organized it a little bit nicer. Flour, rice, flaxseed stuff like that. And then in here, I have all my canned goods. Camera, that's much easier. Okay, so in here I have all my canned goods, as you can see, canned goods, all that stuff. Here I have all my soups and snacks. Okay, down here I have my nut butters and stuff. Again, love these little Lazy Susans, amazing. Here, just have some extra cookies and crackers. Back there, some bigger bulk size chips. And then down here, I have all my pastas and pasta sauces. So you guys, really quick, I just wanted to add this in the video because I ended up putting all my pastas in these jars. Remember, I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do with this jar and that jar. So this is what I utilized them for. I figured it's easy, it's quick. I can just grab the pasta, put it in the pan and go. I'm actually about to cook. I'm not making pasta, but I was just saying, you know, when I'm by the stove, it's easy for me to grab. And then, of course, I had my rice over here. That didn't really change. And then I have my cornmeal over here, so. And then I did go ahead and organize my spices again, just because they kind of got a little bit messy. I had already organized it, but they did get a little messy. So I just went ahead and organized it how I like it. My least used items are kept up here. And then I have the things I use a lot, but not every day. And then I have every single day that I use pretty much every day when I cook. I will reach for things on the shortest section. So I just wanted to update you guys really, really quick. And I like how it turned out. It just looks a lot more organized and neat. And I can easily access what I need. It does not have to be hard, guys, unless you make it hard. So just kind of figure out how you want things, how you want to organize things, and you can do it just like I did. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button and subscribe if you want to see more from me, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.